Welcome to the Galápagos Islands. This is my home, an incredible place, quite unique in landscapes and wildlife. During this journey, the National Geographic Endeavour will take us around these very islands that inspired Charles Darwin to think about variation and change. We're going to travel back in time and see the very life forms that established a long time ago on this particular archipelago and learn about evolution and natural history. This is a great opportunity to have close encounters with very unique wildlife, and we hope you enjoy your trip with Lindblad Expeditions.
North Timor, it is a very tiny island in the archipelago, but it is the home for one of the largest colonies of frigates, blue-footed boobies, and also it is one of the best places in Galapagos to see land and marine iguanas, and along the coast we have the chance to see Galapagos sea lions, and hopefully we'll see swallowtail gulls and many other things. And I hope you enjoy it as much as I do every time I have the opportunity to be in this island.
The Galapagos sea lions are found in many different places around the archipelago. They like to hang out in groups, and they are often very likely to interact with people, and guests like to swim and play around our snorkelers. The female sea lions have usually one pup. Technically, they can have them once every year. They will try to stay with their pup for about a year, and then when they give birth to a new one, then the old pup usually leaves. Galapagos sea lions have a pregnancy of about 9 months, and they will, as all the marine mammals, try to nurse them with very rich milk that is very high in content of fat. Usually we have one beach master controlling a territory, and it will have several females in his harem. He will not be the father of all the pups that we see in the harem. Some of them are from the male that was in that territory the previous year.
Marine iguanas are a unique creature to the Galapagos Islands. They are a true seagoing lizard, the only true seagoing lizard in the world. They are able to swim in strong currents, and they get their food from the depths. Particularly their favorite is seaweed, a green seaweed called alva. And in the Galapagos we have approximately 200,000 distributed all along the shorelines of the various islands. Land iguanas are one of the endemic species of reptiles found in the Galapagos Islands, and they have an ancestor which arrived in the islands about 13 million years ago, and they have adapted to very hostile conditions where most of the year is extremely dry, and they have to really cope with this shortage of food and fresh water. They are very attractive yellow colored, especially towards the mating season. Their yellow scales are enhanced in order to attract a mate into their territories.
So they don't really have anything in common today, although we do have an island in this archipelago in which the land and the marine iguanas are still interbreeding. But the hatchlings are not living enough to reproduce.
Giant tortoises, though, even though they're believed to be very slow, they are actually not that slow. They can walk up to 8 miles per day, a lot more than what we do, at least. Giant tortoises live over probably 200 years. They are very resistant creatures, so they can go for, they can keep on going for a couple of years without any food or water. That is why they were the perfect source of fresh meat and water back in the old times when sailors were collecting them right here. So the only cause of death for giant tortoises in the wild, besides old age, are accidents that males have when mating. If they slid and fall in their backs, they are not going to be able to get back on their 4 feet.
Welcome to Genovesa Island, one of the best places here in the Galapagos to see red-footed boobies and frigate bears. And lucky enough, this time of the year, they are performing their primarian dance, where males, they do inflate this pouch and hoping that some females may approach. And this is an amazing opportunity to get close to Galapagos animals.
Red-footed boobies are perhaps the most colorful of all the birds in the islands, and also one of the birds that flies the farthest. Yes, all of them. That's a beautiful here. You have a chance to observe the juvenile with the brown legs, brown bill, brown body, a bit of downy feathers still on the top of the head. And then you have the adults. They're watching carefully around here.
Males whistle and females honk. Ah. Yeah. Second, body size. The female is a slight larger than the male. Which one do you think is a bit larger?
The one that just got up. Yeah.
The one just, yes, you're right. And then look right into the pupil. One of them has a larger pupil than the other. The one with the larger, that's the female.
Even after 20 years of snorkeling on the world's coral reefs, nothing quite prepared me for the amazing underwater world of the Galapagos Islands. I was simply stunned by the plethora of unique and friendly animals that inhabit these warm waters of the Pacific Ocean. Many different species of fearless sharks casually swim by us on every snorkel. Eagle rays regularly glide gracefully past us without a care in the world. There are also many animals totally unique to the Galapagos Islands, like this marine iguana feeding on the algae. It seems like around every rock there is another fascinating animal waiting for you to meet. This was my first time swimming with sea lions, and it was a real treat. The sea lions love to play in the shallow waters, and if you are lucky enough, you might even get a kiss. But the highlight of my underwater Galapagos experience has to be a close encounter with one of the ocean's true giants, a manta ray.
Hello. Welcome to the National Geographic Endeavor 2. I am Captain Eduardo Neira. I hope you enjoy your expedition in the Galapagos Islands with us.
Hola, my name is Sebastian. I'm the hotel manager. Let me show you around the National Geographic Endeavor 2. This is the sun deck, when you can come back and relax after the expedition or enjoy cocktails during sunset. This is our dining room, where you will enjoy fresh, local, and sustainable international and Ecuadorian cuisine. After your expeditions ashore, you can come back and enjoy a delicious cocktail at the lounge or listen to natural history presentations. All cabins on board the National Geographic Endeavor 2 have large windows, will enable you to enjoy the beautiful scenery of the Galapagos Islands. If you are not too tired after your expedition, you can come back on board and use the fitness center or relax next door with a massage. We also have a fully stocked library where you can learn more about the Galapagos Islands or relax. If you decide to come to the Galapagos Islands, I hope you choose the National Geographic Endeavor 2 for your expedition. See you soon. Ciao.